Whole genome sequencing sequences your entire genetic material. It is in the order of 4,000 times the data that 23andMe or other consumer tests can provide.
So we have actually done whole genome sequencing now on over 400 patients at UCSF. There is information that we can now identify and share with them, and that can be very meaningful to their health because we all are susceptible to something. We all carry a disease gene or few that we can transmit to our children.
My dad died of Alzheimer's, but the symptoms in my dad didn't start showing up until he was 76. Somewhere back in the genome were the traces that said, this is gonna happen, or you're at risk for this, depending on how else you live your life. So if we knew that information then, maybe we could begin to do something about it.
We have identified individuals that are at risk for a number of diseases. They vary from genes that can cause arrhythmias to individuals that are predisposed to having multiple cancers.
The way that the process is working is that your entire genome is sequenced, all 3 billion base pairs. My wife and I did this together. So they got in touch with us and we got in the mail a little spit kit. Just spit it into a tube, drop it in the mail. They tell us about 59 genes for which mutations are known that give risk for disease. And in fact, there are treatments for the disease. As more genes are identified for which there are clear actions and response, that list of 59 will grow.
It's not just your genetics, not just your genome. It's also how genome works with the gut microbiome, how it works with the way you're living or the exposures you're having.
We basically layer the data and say, can we find correlations between data points on one layer to another layer? So that becomes what we call a knowledge network. Then your information would go into that and we'd say, knowing the correlations that we've learned, right, what can we say about you?
I envision that everyone is going to have opportunity to have their genetic material sequenced and that we will know how to individualize the intervention for the patient that is sitting in front of us.
Looking forward in 10 years or 20 years, I think every baby admitted to the NICU or even at birth, you will have your entire genetic material sequenced and it will be there in an iPad. So if your baby develops a seizure and comes into the hospital based on the baby's genetic material, you will be able to see, okay, this seizure medication will work better than the other.
Personally, I'm very, very excited to see and apply the current benefits that we can already share with the patients, but also to see where this journey of discovery is going to go on. I think the genetics has taken a center stage in our research, in our medicine.
The information that you will help put together will serve many future generations. We are just trying to build that infrastructure that is needed for us to go to the next step.